Today I'm going to show you guys how to create this really cool geometric pattern using Adobe Illustrator. I'm not only going to show you how to make it, but I'm going to show you how to crop it and also how to mock it up onto a design using Photoshop. So stay tuned and follow along as we make this really cool geometric pattern using Adobe Illustrator. Yo, what is up people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content, right here on YouTube. This wastes no more time today, and let's jump into the video on how to design this geometric shape using Adobe Illustrator. Make a new document in Adobe Illustrator for your geometric pattern design. And if you're unhappy with the dimensions or the size of your artboard on the screen, you can always take the artboard tool here and adjust your canvas. If you want to, you can show the grid like so. However, it's not essential for today's tutorial. We're going to be using the rotate tool a lot today, but first, let's make sure we have a stroke only in the color palette. You can actually toggle between the stroke and the fill easily with Shift X on your keyboard. Press P for the pen tool and then click once to make an anchor point. You then need to hold down the Shift key to make sure you draw a perfectly straight line upwards. Press V to select off of the pen tool path. With the line selected, press R for the rotate tool and then move the blue target icon all of the way up to the top anchor point. You then need to click once over the icon and then hold down the Alt Option key and click again. In the new window, type in 120 degrees and then you can preview the operation if you want to. Click Copy instead of OK, and then press Command or Control D to repeat the process one more time. A quick reminder for you all in today's geometric pattern tutorial, and that is to turn on the Smart Guide settings, because this is going to help keep your geometric design aligned and equal throughout. Hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate this line here. You then need to move it up to the left anchor point. The smart guides will let you know when it's perfectly in line. Press C on your keyboard to access the scissors tool, or you can always locate them in the tool window. You simply need to click once along the line somewhere to cut it into two sections. This is not a precise measurement, but cut it somewhere similar to mine. Then delete the top section of this line. Press R again for the rotate tool, and drag the icon down to this anchor point here. Like before, click once, and then with the Alt Option key held down, click again. This time you want to rotate this line by 240 degrees. Click Copy. Hold down Shift and then select these two lines here. Then press Command or Control J to unite them together. With the new selection, press R for the rotate tool and drag the icon to the very center of the design. We want to rotate this section by 120 degrees and then repeat the process one more time with Command or Control D. We're actually almost finished making the actual geometric shape in today's Adobe Illustrator tutorial. Next, use the Alt Option key to duplicate this section and place the duplicate like so. Then take the pen tool and draw in a new section perfectly as I'm doing here. And then delete the section we duplicated just now. The line we just drew needs to be rotated with the rotate tool. And yeah, you've probably guessed that it needs to be rotated by 120 degrees and also repeated one more time with Command or Control D. So there is a basic geometric shape for our pattern today. You can go ahead and hide the grid. I'm not actually even sure why I left it open, to be honest. You can hold down Shift and select the outlines of the shape and then increase their stroke weight. You want these lines to be thicker than the central lines of your geometric pattern. Once happy, select everything and then press Command or Control G to group everything together. Having the smart guides turned on is really going to help with this next step. Using the Alt Option key, click and drag to duplicate the shape perfectly over to the right and down a touch. With the shape still selected, press Command or Control D to repeat the process over and over again for your geometric pattern design. It's always a good idea to have an original shape off to the side somewhere to revert back to. Now, select everything and then group it together as well. Then duplicate the section up and to the right perfectly aligned. If you forget to keep the selection selected, Command or Control D is not going to work. So you need to duplicate this section again and then press Command or Control D. Now I'm going to show you how to crop this entire section on the canvas. So make sure that the geometric pattern design does cover the entire artboard and then outline the stroke. There are various different ways to do this, and this is just one method I'm going to show you now. With your pattern selected, go up to Object and create Compound Path. You would then need to lock the geometric pattern and press M for the Rectangle tool. Cover the entire canvas with a rectangle, like so, making sure it's perfectly along the edges. Flick the fill over to a stroke, and then unlock all of the layers. Select the rectangle and the pattern and right-click the selection. You will then need to create a clipping mask. And there you have it, the geometric pattern is cropped perfectly onto the canvas. Finally, I'm going to show you all how to mock up the design onto a book cover. The link for the mockup is in the description below, and we're going to be moving over to Photoshop for this part of the tutorial. So, like I said, there is a link in the description below for this mockup here, and it's totally free for you to download. But once you have downloaded it, go ahead and open up in Photoshop. I'm going to use the original pattern in Illustrator that we just made, and you're going to want to change the color from black to white. Copy the geometric pattern with Command or Control C, and then head over to the mockup in Photoshop. Open the layers window and then locate the layer which says put your design here. Double click that layer and then you can begin to arrange your design, removing layers that you don't want to use and editing other layers such as text. Press Command or Control V to paste your pattern and then arrange it on the canvas. I'm going to use my custom font Satori Sans for this part, and you can download this font via the digital download section of my website, link below. Once happy, go up to File and Save As, and by default it should save the document to temporary files. So go ahead and save it, and then head back to the mockup. And there you have it, your geometric pattern is mocked up onto the book cover like so. there is today's video on how to design this geometric pattern using Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video down in the comment section below. And of course, if you did enjoy it, give it a thumbs up and a comment. If you constantly find my content here at Satori Graphics useful, maybe share my videos on social media so other people can see it too. I hope you guys are really digging my content at the moment. I've been trying to improve my video quality and my tutorials every single video and every single upload. I've got some really cool things planned for the future on this channel, so stay tuned to Satori Graphics and subscribe for weekly graphic design content. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.